Welcome back to My Pre-Loved Affair. If you are new here, my name is Meg. If you've been here before, welcome back. And for those who keep coming back, I really appreciate that. I wanted to talk to you guys today, and this is going to be an update video on a video that I created back in November 2019, which was entitled Raw and Real, My Shopping Addiction. I thought it would be a good time to actually give you an update on what's going on with me and how I've been battling through that and what I have been doing since in order to set myself straight. So let's talk about it. Okay, so in that video, I talked about like what were the things that I kept on buying, how my bag collection has ballooned. It came to a point where I had just under 30 bags. I think I had 27 or something like that. And I was like, I do not need all of these bags. Now, granted, at the time of filming that video in November 2019, I was working from home. This was pre-pandemic, but my job back then was already working from home. So there really was no need for me to have all of those things. Some of the things that I really struggled with was having a lot of time to scroll on social media and seeing all of these influencers talk about their whatever it is that they bought, right? All of these hauls, all of these unboxings and reveals that was really giving me FOMO, right? If we go to the bare bones of this, it really is about the fear of missing out, the fear of not being in, the fear of not being on trend. And who are we really trying to please with these things, right? I remember seeing a quote, it's always attributed to Will Smith, but I think it's been said by many other people before, is that we buy things with money we don't have in order to please the people that we don't like. Right? So I think one of the biggest realizations for me was in that video of Allison talking about fantasy self, that Christina from Stylopathica actually spoke about as well. And I kept thinking to myself, yes, think about that, think about it. Fantasy self, where are you going with all these bags? Where are you going with all these clothes? And I have since decluttered, sold a lot of the things that I bought that I knew I wasn't wearing. And one of the things that I've also done, and I believe I've discussed this before in other videos, was that I created an Excel file with a list of everything that I own, with the exception of socks and undergarments. But everything, shoes, bags, tops, bottoms, dresses, workwear, loungewear, anything that would fall in any category was listed on there. And at one point I had something like 267 items, some of which are multiples. So I have since looked at my closet and done some decluttering. I still have quite a few things. I'm not gonna lie. There's still a lot of things that I need to declutter. But the thing is, I'm not trying to be a minimalist. I'm not trying to pare down my wardrobe to the bare essentials. No, that's not what I'm trying to do. I'm just trying to breathe. I'm just trying to make enough space so that I don't get overwhelmed. I'm just trying to you know, find myself in all of that clutter. Because a lot of the times I can't decide what I'm going to wear because there are so many options. Right? And yet I still end up thinking, I don't have anything to wear. Or I don't have anything that matches with this. But honestly, where am I going? Who's gonna care what I'm going to be wearing? I've taken that, and I actually really need to look at that Excel file again and update it, remove the things that I've already decluttered that's still on that list, and add some things that I've bought over the last 2 years that's not on that list. Because my wardrobe is constantly revolving and my money is also constantly coming in and out of my account. One of the things actually that struck me was that I think one of the reasons why I found buying stuff, especially the pre-loved luxury handbags, why I've been sort of like obsessed with it in the last couple of, well, 2 years maybe, is because I'm able to flip it for more. And you know that rush of buying something low and then selling it for a higher amount for profit, it's like, oh, I want to keep doing that, you know? It's greed, honestly. But when I look at buying things now, I look at, if I resell this, am I going to lose money or am I going to make money? Can I use it until I'm tired of it and then be able to resell it and recoup what I've spent on it? Nowadays, that's usually my frame of mind when I am buying things. Now, you could probably also see that I have got my bags on display, and I'll explain to you why. And if you've been watching me since that video, you would have seen me talk about it in other videos as well. But this really helps me. There are 11 bags on this shelf, soon to be 10, because this Chloe Paddington bag is up on eBay and there's already a bidder, so there's at least, I know that at least one is gonna go. And I do have another 3 bags that are up for sale, so in total I have 14 bags. That's actually, oh, 15 if I include my backpack that I use for work. So I have 15 bags. That's down from 27, and hopefully would be down to 11 if I sell all the 4 that's listed on eBay, Vestiaire, and Facebook Marketplace, right? But I'll come back to that. The reason that I have them on display is because I also found that I keep buying things because I forget that I already have things that are similar to it. I forget what's, because I don't look at my Excel file all the time, and the fact is I haven't updated it in at least 6 months, right? So I keep seeing things that are beautiful, you know, gravitating towards the shiny objects, and not realizing that I actually have something in my closet that would do the same job. Like, for example, and I've spoken about this in a previous video about why my Chanel Classic flap is not staying. I spent a lot of money on that on impulse when my friend asked me if I wanted to buy it from her because she needed cash. And I said that I wanted a classic flap. And so I did buy it. I bought it from her. And I've regretted it ever since because, one, I know she loves that bag. She just needed the money to pay for something emergency, and to, again, as I've said in that video, I never felt that it was my bag. I also find it very impractical, and also I have bags that say that serve the same purpose. Like that classic flap is a lambskin with gold hardware. This is a Coach calfskin with gold or brass hardware. Has the same look, has the same feel, does the same thing, which is store your things so you can carry them around, right? I guess if you go to the very basic reason why you carry bags, it's so that you can bring stuff with you that doesn't fit in your pockets. So I have a lot of bags that will do the same thing. And this, I got this 40% off at the Coach Boutique at Westfield, Sydney. I paid, I think, a little under $500 for this. The Chanel Classic flap, I paid $6,500 from my friend. If I were to buy that at the boutique now, it'll be close to, I believe, $11,000. Right? Can you imagine what else I could have done with that money? Anyway, that bag is going back to its original owner, and I'm getting my money back. And I'll be using this for the purpose that I wanted to use that bag, because honestly, that bag is too classy for me. I mean, it's not my style. And if I'm being honest, the only reason I bought it is because everyone else that I follow on YouTube and on Instagram is like, you need to have it. If you have the opportunity to buy it, buy it. So I did. But since having it, well, one, we're in lockdown, so there's really nowhere for me to use it. But also, it just never felt like me. So I've put my bags on display. I'm gonna come back to the reason why I'm talking about this. And put my bags on display so that I can see them. So that I know what I have and I don't forget and I don't get distracted. I've put them on display so that I know that I have enough and that I don't need any more. Having said that, there is one bag that is coming. I bought it from Vestiaire. It is a Tory Burch bag that looks like a Saint Laurent Toy Lulu. I'll put a picture of it on up here so you guys can see which one I'm talking about. But I was really thinking about buying the Toy Lulu. It's $1,990 here in Australia, brand new. I found the bag, the Tory Burch bag on Vestiaire for, including taxes and shipping, is $383. Right, and it would save a certain purpose. And the reason why I bought that bag is because I've been wanting a white bag with gold hardware. I was even thinking about getting the YSL clutch, monogram clutch, which is $970. But when I think about it, you know, why am I even wanting that? Oh, because it's got the logo YSL, right? And who am I trying to impress with that logo? No one. Nobody cares. I mean, I do have a few friends who are into designer bags as well, but honestly, after they've seen it once, what happens next? That's it, right? So yeah, this is gonna be my bag collection. If you haven't seen it, I've got a video on my curated bag collection and I'll link that somewhere in the description box. I'll also link the video where I talk about why that Chanel Classic Fab is not staying, just in case you haven't seen those. So yeah, I've taken some steps in order for me to mitigate my spending habits. I've now created, at the time of the filming of that original video, I had two accounts. I've now created several sub accounts. One is for an emergency fund, and my goal is to have $10,000 in that account by the end of the year. Okay, and then I'm going to start putting in money into my savings account. Okay, I also have a sinking fund for Christmas to buy presents, and then my normal account where I spend money from, which is essentially if I need to go to the groceries or if I want to buy something for myself. That's what it is. And usually I would keep like $200 per fortnight on there. So I have $100 per week to spend on whatever, right? So I gave myself some leeway like that in order to not feel deprived. But also because we're in lockdown and I'm working from home, I don't really have anywhere to go. Probably the only thing that I spend on is Uber Eats. And that's only when I don't want to cook anything. But we got food at home, right? Another thing that I've started doing is investing on the stock market. I've opened up an account so that I could put money in there for investments. And I've just recently also signed up for on an app that would allow me to invest in the stock market, in cryptocurrency, and all that other money markets. I haven't started yet because I have yet to understand what I need to do, but it's getting there, right? So one of the things that I've decided to do was learn more about finances and about, you know, building and creating wealth. Now, the other thing that I learned about myself in the last 2 years since filming that video is that I have a lot of time in my hands. Like my previous jobs have left me really kind of like twiddling my thumbs because I've gotten so used to the work and gotten so comfortable with it that I could, do things much more quickly and much more streamlined that I'm left with a lot of time in my hands. And what do I do with that time? I watch YouTube. I go on social media, which is not a good idea. So I've actually changed jobs recently. I've only started in my new job on the 16th of August, and it's a very busy job, especially during this time of the year because we're recruiting quite a lot. I work as a recruiter for one of the largest school networks here in Sydney. Okay. And this time of the year is when we start recruiting for the following year. So it's really very busy for us now. Where I find that I don't have time to be scrolling on social media. I don't have time to be looking at what other people have, right? I only have time to be out doing my actual work. And at the end of the day, I'm so mentally exhausted that I would fall asleep. I would go for a nap, or I would watch a little TV, and that was it. So that's been really great. But I also do know that at some point I would get used to this job, and that I would find ways to work smarter instead of harder, and that I would again have time in my hands. So what I decided to do was to pick up a hobby. And I'm currently teaching myself how to play the guitar. Right? Because if I have time in my hands, then I should fill it with something. Otherwise, I would find myself mindlessly scrolling again and looking for stuff to buy. Again, if I have time in my hands, then I should probably be making videos like this, right? And hopefully that's something that would be a little bit more consistent for me, like picking up a hobby. I've started reading a lot of books as well. There was one book that was suggested in the comment section of that original video called 30 Days to Break a Shopping Addiction or Shopping Habit. I just downloaded that on Kindle. Again, I spent. Oh, I only have the sample for now, but if it's a good sample, then I probably will buy it. Those are some of the things that I have been doing to really curb my shopping addiction. I've mentioned this before, and I'm still doing this now. I keep track of who I'm following in social media. I've stopped watching unboxings. I've stopped watching hauls. I've stopped watching shopping vlogs. There is one person that I follow, Remy Rofai. Ron, he does shopping vlogs in the Philippines, show you what's in the market. But honestly, I'm not somebody who would buy something new from the boutiques anyway. It's just too expensive to do that. And again, I have enough, and I can see that I have enough. So really visualizing and putting things in your line of vision keeps you focused. Okay. And when I go and buy stuff, I look at my closet and I say, do I have something similar? Is this going to fill that gap? Do I need it? And then also, I also ask myself the question, especially I find it easier when I am inside the actual shops than when I'm doing it online. Is I hold the material, I look at what it's made of. For example, when I go inside, let's say Uniqlo, I want a t-shirt. I would have a look at the care tag, the composition tag. If it's a synthetic material, I'm not gonna buy it. That's one rule that I have created for myself, not only to stop me from spending, but also to stop me from buying things that are just not good for the environment. And again, I find this easier when I am in the shop. I often would be able to talk myself out of buying things when I am in the shop, and mainly because I don't want to be carrying around paper bags. than when I am online. That's why what I'm focusing now is trying to keep myself offline, or trying to prevent myself from being influenced by content creators. So again, I've stopped following people who only ever show hauls and unboxings and things like that. I've stopped watching those kinds of videos. I've stopped following resale or reselling accounts on Instagram, or put them on mute so that I don't see the things that they're selling, because especially when they try to bait you with all of the sales, oh, it's so hard. But also, no, because I also keep thinking back to my youth, and how often I went shopping when I was young, and it was like Christmas and the start of the school year, and that was it, because there was a budget, so and there was five of us that my parents had to spend on, so we had to be really careful with our spending. And I'm trying to bring myself back to that time and sort of like take lessons from then, because honestly, we're almost coming out of lockdown here in Sydney, and when that happens, the pre-loved markets will reopen, and I'm kind of trying not to be, not to go. But it'll be a struggle. I know it'll be a struggle, but I really just need to be able to tell myself, no, you don't need that, right? I'm still struggling. It's still there, but I'm getting better at it. I don't have any credit card debt, zero, as in zero. I've got savings, and I've got an emergency fund going. So, and I've got investments. So I think I'm doing it slow, but I think I'm doing it right. So yeah. Let me know in the comment section down below your thoughts about shopping addiction, about spending habits, and maybe give me some suggestions on what else I can do to keep me occupied and stop myself from buying things that I don't need. So far, I think I'm doing well, and I've been pretty consistent. So yeah, leave them in the comment section down below. And if you are struggling and on the same boat, you can do this.